Right, lads, in position. Department of Audience, ready?
Yes!
Cranberry Centenary Parade rehearsal starts now! We say, God bless you, to the Cranberry dance instructor! We say, hats off, to the Cranberry Union of Miners!
Oh, great, Steve, what's that?
It's the miners' trike.
Get out. We say thanks a million to the Cranberry nurses. Actually hurts. Get off. We say keep up the good work, Cranberry bungee jumpers. We say fond regards to the Cranberry fashion designers.
Is it, Steve? You have pushed me too far. I'm trying to organise a credible centenary parade here, and you two are just coming on dressed as dicks.
Wait a minute, Greg. Let me put the icing on the cake.
Oi, Steve. Look, I'm sorry about your ears.
It's all right, I'm sorry about your hand.
There's nothing wrong with my hand. What's this? Is this a mongoose? Is this a mongoose?
Never cross me.
Look, let's just try and be friendly for once, can we? What are you doing?
Sneaking in.
What do you mean, sneaking in? I've just seen you. You're an hour late. Didn't you use that alarm clock we bought you?
Oh. Hello? Hello? Max, how's it? Max speaking, how can I help you? I think it was the wrong number.
Oh, Popeye the failure man.
Stephen, what did I just say to you about being friendly? How would you like if I called you names, eh? How'd you like if I said you had a horribly stretchy face? If I said you had ears like dustbin lids, would you like that? What if I said I'd seen your genitals and it looked like someone shaking a dead lamb in the air? Yeah, would you like that? No. It's not nice bullying, is it? Mm. It's easy to pick on a soft target.
Oh. Everything stayed on.
I glued them on for you.
That's more like it, Steve. You see, we're friends and we're colleagues. Right, boys, to business. Marek, do you know what today is?
Happy birthday, Greg?
Not 100 years of age. I'm 33. What did I tell you in our weekly meeting?
Orange is not the only fruit.
What I actually said is that today is the most important day in the history of Cranberry. A day when we get to remember what made this town great. Do you know how long we've waited for this centenary?
Oh, it's plus something about four.
It's 100 years, Marek.
Oh, yes.
Yes. The mayor has honoured us, boys, with the duty of immortalising the memories of this town. Forever, in a nutshell, in a time capsule. Do you mind?
No, my hands are stuck. Oh, quick, your alarm clock's going off.
Your ladyship. Yes, yes, so sorry. Yes. We'll be there in two shakes.
Nice. Banana. Fresh. Low fat. That is tasty. Strawberry. Lovely contrast. That is lo- I mean, that would be a lovely breakfast. Tasty.
Why, lads? There's not a second to lose.
Has anyone seen Mr. Snick yet?
Steve, get the stuff for the time capsule. The mayor's waiting. If we don't get there pronto, there's going to be a lynching.
It's OK, Greg. I've got some lynching vouchers.
Greg, have you seen Mrs. Sneed, sir?
Right, boys. Let's take the greatest memory this town's ever had and bury them in a hole in the ground.
Bring forth the accused. You three men.
I'm a woman, you sexist pig.
You two men and a woman are accused of the following heinous crime.
Do a shit or a space cat.
If you knew that cat, you'd have done the same.
Enough! That was my cat, and now it absolutely stinks. I sentence you to spend the rest of your lives trapped in space forever.
Your ladyship.
Why the bloody hell have you been immoral and lardy?
Your reverence, just making final preparations for our special day.
The only thing special about today is your needs. Well, come on, let's get this over and done with. Look at him. Bloody vermin.
Citizens of Clangbury, it's wonderful to see so many of you coming out to celebrate this day.
Who are you?
I'm the deputy mayor.
Oh, no, you're bloody not.
Citizens of Clangbury, today we celebrate 100 years of our glorious town. But first, we must remember that it is 24 years ago to this very day since the terrible Clangbury Bear tragedy. Not forget, this is also the 15th anniversary of the Clangbury race riots. My friends, the days of freak events are long behind us. And so, as we look to the future, what better way to mark the 100th year of Clangbury than with the restocking of the Clangbury Mobile Library? With the modification of the Clangbury Telecoms Tower. And with the little amount of money that was left, I am humbled by the small tribute to myself, the Clangbury bronze. And to immortalise the centenary and preserve this great age for our children and our children's children, we are going to fill up this time capsule with items that best represent our wondrous town. firstly. A leaflet from Clangbury's premier pizza restaurant, Pizza Gut.
To recognise Clangbury Industry and free lunchtime deals.
Steve, you sure this isn't the rubbish bag?
And secondly, a copy of Pam's Javelin, what?
To symbolise the cleaning of our streets of pornography.
That's yours, isn't it, Greg?
And finally, a cuddly alien. Now, the sooner we bury this lot, the better.
I've got a better idea. I reckon we should fire it into space.
Oh, right, Steve, yeah. Where from? The Clangbury Space Centre?
No!
Gregory Chrysanthemum Davis. From this! My magnificent catapult. Feast your eyes.
Steve, have you tested that?
Naturally.
Are you sure this is...
Oh, no, Mr. Snitzer!
You've desecrated the statue!
And the library and the telecoms tower.
Get the library and the telecoms tower! You had better fix this, or all of you will get your P-45.
We get 45p. Greg, do you think aliens will bring back Mr. Snitzer?
There's no such thing as aliens, man. Just as there's no such thing as Father Christmas.
No.
There's no such thing as pixies. There's no such thing as elves. There are no fairies at the bottom of your garden. There's no such thing as a wheat intolerance. And now there's no such thing as Mr. Snitzer.
On the fifth moon of the new year, the men shall come, and they shall bring back you, Mr. Snitzer, and there will be crime on the streets. In this little great boy.
Stephen, have you been putting paint stripper in his squash again?
No, he's been like this ever since Snitzer left.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, Stephen, you fired his only friend into space. And more importantly, now I can't find a number for pizza. What are you going to do about it?
All right, slim down.
Think you mean calm down?
No, I don't.
Oh, unity, Steve, unity!
It's all right, Greg, I've sorted it. I've got my latest creation. This, my friend, is Mrs. Snitzer. And this is a number with which to get pizza.
Merrick! Oh, Merrick! I've got a little surprise for you.
Mrs. Snitzer!
No, it's a new, even prettier friend. It's Mrs. Schnitzer!
Oh. Oh, hello, Mrs. Schnitzer. Yeah. How are you today?
And look, there's a little note she's written for you inside her nose.
Let's see what she says. Yes.
You killed my husband.
Stephen, go and sit on the naughty step.
What is this strange contraption that's brought us freedom?
Ooh. Meat feast!
Strange, but somehow attractive.
Meat feast!
Strange, but somehow attractive.
It says it's from Clangbury. Maybe we should go there and make friends.
It's told me two things. Firstly, to stop holding its anus to my ear. And secondly, that Clangbury is full of idiots and must be destroyed. Destroyed immediately. How do we get there?
One moment. foul creature!
Yes, love.
Show us Clangbury, or fill my wrath.
Oh, all right. Well, just carry on to Jupiter, and then bear left and follow the smoke. Then when you get to Earth, turn right at the post office. He said I could feel his wrath. I haven't felt anyone's wrath since we went decimal.
The boy who never evolved, still sulking.
He's not sulking, Steve. He's upset.
Marek, you've got to try making new friends. Real friends.
Oh, like Father Christmas. And the Tooth Fairy. And pixies at the bottom of the garden.
Yes.
Or like Mervyn the Turd Dragon.
Oh, who's he?
He's a dragon who flame grills his own turds and then throws them at baddies.
Oh, well, he sounds nice.
Yes. Except he doesn't exist!
Yes! You've got to try making real-life friends.
I don't know how to do that.
Well, I've been teaching Steve how to make new friends. Mm. Yeah? He can show you. Mm.
With the Department of Audience! Steve, show Marek how we make friends.
Watch and learn, Marek. Hello. Will you be my friend?
No.
Is it because I've got massive ears?
Yes.
Hello, will you be my friend?
No.
Is it because of my gigantic, stretchy face?
That's correct.
Freak. Hello, will you be my friend?
No.
Is it because of my weird dead lamb nuts?
A little bit.
Going well. Hello, will you be my friend?
No.
Is it because you look like a rent boy? Will you be my friend?
No.
Racist! Will you be my friend?
No.
Asshole!
So alone.
And that, Marek, is how you make friends.
I don't think either of you know anything about friendship.
Why don't you try and explain it to us?
I can't really put it into words.
No? Mm. How do you think you could best express the importance of friendship?
Maybe in a song.
We are nothing without our friends. Life is never empty when they call. We are nothing without our friends. Only they can pick you up when you fall.
Friend will be there for you in your darkest hour. Friend will hold your hand when you fail. The world is up against you. We are nothing without our friend. Only they can help you when you're down. We are nothing without our friend. We can make a smile from a crowd. Holding me now. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. We are nothing without our friends. Only they can help you.
Has that made you feel better?
No.
Why don't you watch your favourite show? Alcoholics Say the Funniest Things.
Ooh. You think you're better than me, don't you?
We interrupt this programme for a special news report.
Incredible scenes here in Clangbury as these three strangers seem to be turning the town upside down, literally. No one has any firm idea where the peculiar trio are from. Some say the circus, others say don't know, why are you asking me? Whoever they are, they certainly seem to be righting so many of the wrongs recently performed by our inept council. Take a look at this.
Ah!
I've managed to get hold of one of the mysterious strangers with me now.
Oh, Mrs. Snitzer! Oh.
Why are you here in Clangbury?
Firstly, to get pizza. Secondly, to subscribe to Pan's Javelin. And thirdly, to seize control of Clangbury and run it as we see fit.
What do you think the head of the council will say about this?
You're talking to the new head of the council. We're heading there now while I shall destroy all who oppose me.
Wow, that sounds like the most fun to hit Clangbury since Peter Piccolo.
Peter Piccolo!
Yes, Peter Piccolo. You heard it here first. The mayor and the councillors are in line for certain death.
Mr. Sneeze is back! Mr. Sneeze is back!
Did you not hear what that bloke just said? They're going to kill us all!
Hooray!
Not hooray!
Oh. If they
kill us, we'll almost certainly lose our jobs.
Let's go to work.
Behold, gentlemen, I am become death.
And that is?
I call it the weapon of omnipotent force. Or woof for short.
Use the weapon, Steve.
DEFCON 1, full power!
Well, that seems to have done the trick.
Who is the one you call leader?
Well, I'm deputy mayor. I mean, I hope to be mayor one day. I don't know whether... Who are you three men?
I'm a woman!
Are you? You are... I mean, you are disgusting. I mean, you are... You are a hooner. You are a munter! Oh, my God! I mean, repellent.
Come on, Grace, she's not that bad.
Have you seen her? Look at her stretchy face and her massive nose and her, oh, her ears.
I hate her! I hate her!
I think she's quite pretty.
What? Are you joking?
You are disgusting. I mean, you are...
What, she'd be an ugly bloke. She...
Oh! I know for a fact, Greg, that you have been very glad of a lot worse.
What the hell is going on? I want an explanation this second, or I will steam press your man breasts.
I'm a woman!
Let me put this a little more simply. Someone tell me what is going on, or I will kill the lot of you!
There's actually no need. We're about to kill everyone.
Oh, finally, someone who can get things done.
I think when he says everyone, he's including you.
Right, well, if I'm dead, who's going to stroke my massive spaniels? This is the final straw. You're all fired!
No, your ladyship. Let me die with some dignity. Help! Help!
Quick, I could ask some of my friends to help fight the baddies.
Oh, it's wrong with you. You haven't got any friends. You imagine them all.
Do I, though? Father Christmas!
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
The Tooth Fairy!
Always brush after meal times.
Picked it from the bottom of the garden!
We found this in your hedge. Debaser.
What the hell's that?
He's got a wheat intolerance.
Don't worry, we'll sort these alien arseholes out.
Hooray! My friends have saved the day!
What friends? I told you, they don't exist.
Oh, at least the aliens are dead.
What aliens?
There aren't any aliens. Departive audience! Hooray! Well, at least the mayor won't sack us.
Oh, I won't sack you.
Does this mean you're leader of the council now, Greg?
Council, Marek?
If there's no council, where do we work?
We, Marek.
Mr. Snitzer! Greg, Steve! Oh, it was all just a nasty dream.
No, it wasn't, Marek.
Oh! It can't just be me. It can't just be me. Oh, Mervyn the Turd Dragon. It can't just be me and you.
That may have been the last in the series of We Are Clang, but its replacement is equally good. The brand new series Lunch Monkeys begins next Thursday at 10:30 on BBC Three. Family Guy next tonight.